Okay. Yes, so what is assertive?
Assertive means putting across your views authentically without hurting others.
Without hurting others. Okay. So he's correct. He's, what do you say, Lord? Say simple English, it's because you're high-flown English. Is there a simple?
Assertiveness is very pleasantly standing by what you said.
What, yeah, okay, standing by what you said. Oh, your own rights. Okay. Aap kya bolenge, wohi bolenge?
Same thing.
Same thing, okay. It, in simple English, it means to state confidently.
Yeah. Confident.
Simple English. Now, you see, when things are okay, when people are friendly, helpful, cooperative, collaborative, okay, then there is no problem. Life goes on smoothly. Right? But in real world, we don't find life like that. You see, we come across people who want to take undue advantage of us, who want to score points over us, who want to exploit us, who want to manipulate us, all sorts of things. You see. And there are conflicts to take place. So, in such a situation, your behavior becomes very important. Okay. So, by and large, fundamentally, there are three behavioral processes to respond to this type of situations. Those three are, first is submissive. It is also called passive. Okay. Second is aggressive. And third is assertive. Okay, so some people respond submissively or passively, some are aggressive, etc. So what is the difference between passive? What happens is you don't stand up for your rights. You are telling rights. You don't stand up for your rights, and even if you stand up for your rights, you do it so weakly that it is very easy for the other person to disregard it.
Allowing others to bully you.
Yeah, bully you, ride roughshod over you, see. And that can happen anything, husband and wife situation, father and son, father and daughter, two friends, boss and subordinate, and across the, on the street also you meet people. With anybody it can happen like that, okay. So that is submissive behavior. Actually, in brief, that is submissive behavior. You don't stand for your right. And even if you stand for your right, you do it so weakly that it is very easy for people to disregard it, to ride roughshod over us, okay. In other words, when you are submissive, you are putting yourself down and putting others up. You know, you are putting others up and you are putting yourself down, okay. What would be aggressive behavior as opposed to submissive? Aggressive behavior will be when the person, what do you say, is that He stands for his right, as he said, but he does in a manner in which hurts others,
yes,
which is insulting to others.
At the cost of others.
He's not considerate to the feelings, etc.
He just wants what he wants, and he does it. He hurts people, etc. Now, that in brief is aggressive.
People misinterpret
that
aggressive is assertive.
Yeah, that's the thing. Aggressive is not, you're right. Yeah, that's why you have to be clear, you have to be very clear. So that is, in the first instance, that passive person is a slave to his fears. He's always afraid. He karega to boss aisa bolega, he karega to aisa to karega. See, and in the second place, aggressive person is a slave to his anger. He gets angry and he shouts, etc., and he throws things around, okay. So supposing a passive person is, now let's give an example to understand passive behavior better. Person has borrowed some money from his friend for a few thousand rupees. He wanted badly. His wife was in the hospital. He has lost his job and he needs money. Everybody needs money, so he needs money. The friend has given him the money. Okay. Now 1-2 years have passed. The friend has not returned. And now he's in a good position in the sense that his wife is out of the hospital. She's got a job. She's working, contributing to the family income. The husband also has got a good job, better job. He's also. But this man wants the money, you know, he wants the money which is given, but he does not go and ask directly. He'll tell him indirectly, talk about expenses being so high, aajkal bahut cheez ki zarurat padti hai, I don't know, but he will not ask in a plain, simple manner, And Rama, give my money, when am I going to give my money back? That is passive behavior. Aggressive behavior will be at the same instant, you take the same example. So this fellow, when he sees his, he happens to see him in the mall or some shopping center, he goes up to him, catches him by the neck and tells him, what do you mean by coming in the mall and earning money? You owe me money, you're not giving me my money and you're doing this. You can't, how can you purchase this? So sabke samne usko insult karta, hurt karta. Okay. So this is the approach of the stupid. Now, what happens? The aggressive hoga to, are there any benefits?
Yes, sometimes, depending on the situation.
Okay.
If you have the power and you want to get it done,
okay,
sometimes the aggressive is helpful.
In
but only short time.
It is in Marathi, there is a saying, thaka se thaka.
Means?
Thaka se mahatak. Means? You
there
know.
Are some people who are
truly. So, even assertive, sometimes it will not. It has to be aggressive.
Aggressive.
With power. Somewhat yeah. Short time.
So, aggressive helps you to be successful in getting what you want. Getting what you want, you are successful
but
getting
it. You are not happy.
That, okay, you get what you want. It gives you the feeling or a sense of power over others. Power over others. And it also helps you to dispel feelings of anger and frustration. But what goes against aggressiveness is that it will create enemies, you will spoil relationship. And you will create enemies. That is, you spoil the relationship and you create enemies.
And success is temporary.
Temporary, sometimes it's temporary, that's right. Okay. Now we will see what is assertive behavior. As against these two, aggressive, you got the aggressive part and passive or submissive you got. So what would be assertive? Assertive is a person who stands for his right, who but he does it in a way that doesn't hurt the other person.
Yeah,
he doesn't. Okay. Assertiveness means the ability to talk in an open, honest manner.
Honest.
Yeah. So in that situation also, when that person has not given the money, he'll go and ask him for the money. It will lead to an open, honest conversation. Maybe in which he will understand the need of the other person, but without sacrificing his own rights. Okay. So that will be assertiveness, okay. And he may even work out with him a repayment program, EMI, whatever it is, you know. Yeah. So that will he'll be there, that he'll keep in, he'll understand the feelings and the difficulties of the other person. At the same time, he will assert his own rights, put across. So assertive person is able to talk about his feelings, his motives, and his thoughts, beliefs, etc. In a positive manner, in a cool, collected, calm manner. It's very rational, cool, collective. Okay. So in this case, I told you, what will he do if the friend doesn't give him the 50,000 rupees that he has borrowed? He'll go and tell him and request him. It will look like a request, all this claiming it. But and if that fellow is not able to do, then he may suggest some ways. Like, how can we do it, etc. And work out something. Okay.
Work out probable solution.
Okay, correct. So in assertiveness, you act in harmony with your self-respect. Your self-respect doesn't go, your self-esteem remains, etc. Okay. In other words, you can say assertiveness is being in touch with your true feelings. Okay. Or being true to yourself. So how will you recognize these three types of behavior? So there will be some characteristic things that they will be doing.
The submissive one is always nodding to whatever means, accepting whatever the other person even if it is conflicting with his own beliefs.
Okay, yeah, okay.
He will accept.
What about his communication, how will it be?
One will be tone will immediately, I mean, and the volume.
Volume also.
Volume. Because aggressive volume will be high, and tone also will be, a pitch will be high, and submissive will speak slowly.
What about the content? What about the content?
Content also.
Sir, bolo, what about the content also? You'll find one characteristic of a submissive man, that he'll make long winded statements, rambling statements. Idhar se udhar, udhar se idhar jata. He doesn't talk to guma guma firai. Okay, that
you
will not come to the. Yeah, okay, that's right. And then he'll make qualifying statements. You know, to just most of the time he'll justify himself. I saw kya, then I went there. And something like that. You know, without coming to the point straight away. Okay, and he'll use phrases. Qualifying is maybe, it may happen, maybe, would you mind if I do
directly,
you will not speak. And he will cut his own self by giving qualifying remarks, you know. I only meant like that, I didn't mean it this way, etc.
Avoid
eye contact. That is, when he'll avoid eye contact. And he'll always talk, you know, you'll see the number of times he'll say sorry to bother you, I didn't mean to hurt you, I didn't mean to this thing. He'll keep on, when and then, you know, he'll use what we call filler words. Fill up I know my boss was then, every second sentence he would say, you see. Do you follow me, you see, etc. That way it goes on, etc. Okay. Okay also they'll say many times, okay, and then they have a tendency, you're telling them, Lord, I'll put it in this, and I said, a submissive person has a tendency to put himself down. I can't understand this, I never can understand this, computers is not for me, this is too much, you can do it, etc. You'll always find that, you know, for anything, because any work also has to be given to him, he gets into defensive, okay. So, and he puts himself down and puts the other person, and the aggressive person is the reverse. He puts himself up and he puts the other person down. So this is what he will do. And then he'll use, submissive person will use words or phrases which will make it easy for the other person to say. I'm asking something from you, it is mine, I deserve it. I'm a submissive person. I tell you that I want it, and then I say, no, Shirish, it's all right. It doesn't mean all that. It's not so important. It's not so important. I'm just supposing you can manage to do it, then give it to me. Otherwise, so this is very apologetic, very good word. Uncalled for. So Shirish will say, okay, then think. There are people like that in this world. Okay. Okay, so this way you will recognize a person who is passive, his attitude. What about the person who is aggressive, people behave aggressively, they are likely to make excessive use of I statements. I am like that, I am this, I did like that, always I will be there. Okay, and they will state their opinions as facts. You talk to them, suppose you, let's say, take the latest is going, discussion going on is, should India play cricket in the World Cup, or where Pakistan is playing, no? Now everybody can have his own view on this thing, I don't want to say anything because, okay. But that aggressive person, suppose you say, yeah, what is that, we should play cricket, actually. And if I'm aggressive, I'll say, that's nonsense, you're talking rubbish. This is what it is, it's not fact-based. But feeling with rubbish,
immediate
cut, absolutely, his opinion becomes like fact, that's the thing, okay. And then aggressive person will use threats, I'm warning you, this is, I'm warning you, this is going to happen to you, then don't blame me, things like that, okay. Or I will not take the risk, if you want, you do it, but you'll have to take the blame, etc., okay. The other one is that, he makes him feel ridiculous by putting him down. Suppose you make a statement, you know, India should go to Karachi and play, let's say. And immediately I will tell you what? What will I tell you?
Nonsense.
What are you talking nonsense? Okay. You must be joking. Do you really believe it's nonsense? What are you talking about? How can this be, etc.? Okay. Another feature about an aggressive person will be, they will use words like you should,
you ought to do it, you must do it.
That is how they talk. The language is that. You must do it. You should do it. You ought to do it. And lastly, they'll blame if things go wrong. It's your fault. I blame you. You ought to have done like that.
By the whole world.
Whole world, but yeah. We'll never take the responsibility. So that is aggressive behavior. Okay. What about assertive person? All good things.
Will not say, he will put up the fact first. This is the statement, or this is the requirement because of these.
Okay.
And based on that, then he will say other person to make a judgment without losing his own calm.
Very good, excellent. Aap, you would like to? Sahab, aap kuch bole na? Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
Stand by his this without disturbing the other person's emotion.
Okay. How is the communication will be? One chief characteristic of an assertive person is that he'll talk in short sentences. Short. Mm. Okay. He'll make statements that are brief and to the point.
Yeah.
To the point and they are brief. You see, all extraneous matters will just go. That is his normal thinking. Okay. Then he'll use well-conceived I statements, you know. I did like that, or I am like that, but not like excessive use, etc. Okay. Like he'll say, I think, I feel, I believe, I think, etc. I like also. Okay.
In my opinion.
That will come next. He'll distinguish clearly between facts and opinion. What do you think? He'll say, yes, in my opinion, as I see it.
He will put forward clearly what he wants in it.
And my experience has taught me this.
Yes.
So, he'll talk in that way. It is my observation that.
He will put across things like that so that other person, other party will think it over.
Correct.
Create a situation so that other party will think it over.
So he'll regard the other person as equal and treat him accordingly.
Give the chance to the other person to reconsider
his. Yeah, he'll reconsider, to rethink.
Yeah.
And he also is trying to
open
to that person's suggestion to reconsider. Very good, excellent. Okay. And another aspect of assertive person will be that he will be using open-ended questions.
Open-ended.
You know what is open-ended and closed-ended?
Yeah.
Closed-ended can be answered in one word.
Not the final statement.
Yeah.
Open-ended is open to correction.
Open to correction and open to discussion and all that. Like for example, what do you think we should do? That is an open-ended question. Do you think this is better than that? Should we change this to that?
Not only in yes, no.
Not in yes, no. And close-ended is, are you coming with me? No. Finish, over. But what will happen if you don't come tomorrow? Then this can happen. That's open. So he'll use open-ended questions to find out the other person's beliefs, thoughts, opinions, what he wants, what he likes, all those things. Okay. And lastly, an assertive person will look for solutions. Look for methods, ways to solve the problems. So if we do this, what will happen? Can we consider doing this? You know, all sorts of things are put forward. Instead of having a class on Saturday, if you have it on Sunday morning, what is going to happen? Whatever it is, you know, it may be as simple as that, or it may be a big thing also. Okay, but this is what they will do. Now, can aggressive behavior be successful? Yes, as I told you. Yeah. But it can lead to bad relations, and then it can create enemies also, and it will create mostly
bitter
unpleasantness. It will create all around you, there will be unpleasantness. And what will happen is that person who is aggressive, people will be waiting for a chance to give it back to him somewhere.
Yes.
You know? So
opposite party will think for revenge.
Yeah. Although at times it is necessary to be aggressive to get the work done.
Sometimes it is. But only for a short
time. Yeah. Okay. Submissive person, what is the advantage of being submissive? Main thing is he will avoid confrontation.
Sometimes submissive behavior is a life-saving
also. Life-saving also, correct.
Like if you meet some gunda something, at that time you cannot be aggressive. If he is having a pistol
absolutely.
Knife, you cannot be aggressive.
Okay, I'll tell you, I was going to tell you at the end, but I'll tell you now. But again, one word you must remember, when you are being assertive, one of the things you require is, you should be able to discern. Yeah, judgment should be there. What stage, what you have to do, as you say. What you said, all that I can put in one word, you should have the ability to discern. Okay, that's correct. So submissive person will avoid confrontation, avoid fights, pleasantness, no, peace of mind. That is it. But what is the
disadvantage?
Misery to him, yeah. And his life will be, life and aspirations will be doing other what other people want him to do.
Giving signal to other person, same thing.
He'll surrender his life. Now, in India, you must be sure, in every home, I think the wife surrenders.
He's submissive.
The wife is forced to be submissive. Now it is changing in cities like Bombay. Okay.
Because of mainly economic reasons.
Yeah, whatever it is, okay, and we'll come to causes also. So, now, these are the advantages of aggressive behavior and submissive behavior has got with the defects also. What is good about assertive? Now, why are we wasting time talking about assertiveness here? What is good about assertiveness?
Because almost more than 70-80% of time you are successful. Means you lead to solution.
Okay. What else?
Without creating disharmony, the person is getting
relationship.
Okay. Very good. Okay.
Work done.
Right. Work done. I'll give you some 5 or 6 points. Huh? I'll give you in addition to what you said. First thing is, assertive people are generally more confident.
Yes. Yes.
And they are less punishing, and less anxious also. Okay.
They know their job, yeah.
And they are what you are saying, one word which I like, proactive.
Proactive, yes.
They make things happen. They don't wait for things to happen. They go create things. They make things happen. Another thing about assertive people is that they are very good at focusing on real issues. Because they don't allow these extraneous things to come, the distractions to come. So they focus on real issues.
First thing.
And because they are able to do that, also, another good point is that they are good at listening.
Yes.
Which is very important. That topic will take listening.
Yeah.
I had done it some years ago, I think, listening. I think so, I don't know.
Yes.
Year or some. Yeah. There I had done. No?
So being a good listener, a person cannot be assertive.
Correct. Yeah, correct. Yeah. And if a person is assertive, he will be a good listener.
Good listener.
Okay. Then they are objective. Also, as you said, they don't jump to conclusions. Aggressive persons are subjective, they take it personally, etc. Assertive person looks at the facts. It's evidence based, everything is fact based, evidence based, not feeling based. Okay. Then assertive persons can, as you put it, but I'm putting it, they can resolve conflicts and complaints, etc. They can, by applying their mind.
They will not see problem. As a
challenge. That's right. Are they good at communication? Very much.
Yeah,
of course, they are very good at communication. Because I told you, they make short sentences. Okay, small, short statements. That is it. And they have harmony.
With
their own thoughts also. And
to the point, you know. They will not speak about the bush.
Right. That is so. That communication is good, to the point, good audible voice, etc. And more importantly, it is congruent with the non-verbal communication. They are in harmony. Non-verbal and verbal are in harmony. You see.
Right.
Yeah. So you can't say, "Give me my money." No.
Yeah.
This, you see, there is a clash. My voice is trying to assert and be aggressive, but my behavior is of. Yeah, but whereas if I'm assertive, I say, "Yeah, come on, lad, you have taken too long. Now give me my money."
Yeah.
So it is congruent. I am looking in his eyes and talking. You saw the first example. I say, "I'm looking down." Okay, so they are there. Communication. Of course, assertiveness leads to, in the long run, better relationship with this, with friends, with society. Quality of life improves. Assertiveness helps you to maintain self-respect also.
Yes.
The submissive person, God, okay. And assertiveness helps you to avoid exploitation manipulation. If somebody tries to exploit you, take advantage of you, etc., you will be assertive and stand up to your rights, etc. Okay. So these are the varied advantages of being good about being assertive. Therefore, it is worth being assertive, trying to be assertive to the extent it is possible. Okay.
Yes.
Now, if assertiveness has got so many good points, why is it that we are not naturally assertive?
Most of the people act with their emotions.
With their emotions.
Okay. And that comes in the way of effective communication.
Okay.
Actually, I feel one of the major points, because we are not assertive from the beginning, is because of our childhood condition.
Exactly. Yeah. Very good. That's actually very important. So our social class is important. See, assertiveness comes easily and naturally to persons who are exposed to good education, to privileges, to riches. Okay, then Ambani's son will be you don't have to tell him to be assertive. Okay. Yeah, there are more chances than unless. Okay. So most of us do not have. So these people who have got privileges, education, etc., money, they have a background of self-assurance. Wherever they go, you know, they go to a hotel and they have to have something, they can do it in a self-assured way. People like me go to the hotel, not but there were times when we used to go, first thing we would look at the right-hand side of the menu card.
Yes.
Yeah. Isn't it? Yeah. Because we don't have that assurance, we don't have enough money, etc. Okay. So that is the first reason why we tend to get submissive. Okay. Second is our gender. You see the way the girls are brought up. They're told from the beginning to listen to their brothers,
yes,
to do what the brothers tell, fathers tell, to obey everybody.
Kane ko jen pehle
bhejenge. All those things.
This is not correct.
Not correct, whatever it is, but it happens. And that makes the girls submissive, submissive, and encourages the boys to be aggressive.
Yes.
Yeah, isn't it? Usko marta hai, usko paisa le leta hai, ye karta hai, anything he does, okay, fine then. Third is, in our schools also the same thing happens. The student or the boy or the girl who's quiet, who doesn't demand things, okay, who's obedient, does homework well, comes on time, etc., they like it. The boy who questions, many teachers also, they don't like questioning, they don't encourage. It's troublesome business. So in school, because then life becomes easier for them, no? Yeah. So what happens to those people? They also say that in life they learn that it's better to keep quiet, better not to talk up, better not to give your opinion, better not to differ in your opinion with people, etc. So that's another thing. Fourth is, as you said, early in life you are told to keep quiet. The person who keeps quiet is nice. I know the dialogues you also be doing something like, "Arey, mera papu to kitna acha hai, sab baat sunta hai." Don't you hear that? You say it with so much pride in front of your guests and your other relatives and all that.
The best.
And udhar, udhar, usko kya lagega? The other person who is not quiet, he'll start becoming aggressive. He'll start feeling, kya kar raha hai, okay. And lastly, also very, to some extent, our culture, our religion also is responsible.
Yeah.
Our religion keeps on telling you, forgive, be quiet, be so. It's in the Bible very clearly, it says, if somebody slaps you on one cheek,
give
the other cheek to him. Isn't it? Yeah. And one more thing, it says that, the meek is the mild, that means they shall,
that is
the meek shall inherit the earth.
Yes, yes.
So सबको मिलेगा ना, ऐसा बोलते हिंदू एंड मुस्लिम मिलते क्यामत के दिन इसमें ऐसा मिल जाएगा, अभी कुछ करने दे, कितना कितना साल करेगा तू, 50, 60, 70 साल करेगा ना, बाद में तो लाइफ टाइम यू आर गोइंग टू बी इन हेवन एंड हेल, ऑल दिस टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स हैव इन्फ्लुएंसेस अस. यू ब्रॉट इट आउट करेक्टली बाय सेइंग दैट हाउ वी आर, इन अदर वर्ड्स हाउ वी आर ब्रॉट अप. सो असर्टिवनेस रिक्वायर्स ओरिजिनलिटी, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ थिंग्स हैव हैपेंड टू यू इन योर लाइफ. See, now I'm retired and I'm not doing much work and I get time to myself. I'm able to automatically think of some situations that happened and how I behaved and how I could have behaved and how I might behave now and what happened, etc. You get time for introspection. Okay, right? Now, so we have covered all these things. Now we come to what, I don't know whether you can call it controversial or not, but the heading is assertive rights. There's time now, 15-20 minutes left, no?
Yes, I think.
15. So, what is known as assertive rights. So, we all have our rights, assertive rights. However inferior a human being might be, he has got his rights. Is it? And we should exercise our rights. Okay. Sometimes we forget. My right is as important as your right and yours is as important as his right.
Every life
is important. Yeah, right. But we sometimes forget and we feel that the rights of other persons are more important than our rights. Yeah. There's nothing like that. It is not like that. Okay. Therefore, stop thinking like that. Your right is equal right as anybody else. So, learn to claim your right. Most of the time, we don't claim our right. Now, what are the rights? Can you tell me how many rights? In simple rights. Right to your opinion.
Yes.
Okay.
Right to give
you your opinion. Right to ask for what I want. Okay. I have a right to ask you for whatever I want. The corresponding is, you have a right to say no. Fine, it's okay. But you can't say, but you know some dialogue, I said yesterday I was seeing something on the YouTube, some picture or some clip, something. And this man gets a little intimate physically with that woman. And one sentence she says, क्या समझते हैं तुमको कैसा लगा कि तुम मेरे साथ ये कर सकते हो ना. शी इज शाउटिंग एट ही टुक अ चांस बट दिस इज अ थिंग इट इज यू नो सो दैट सो आई कैन आस्क फॉर व्हाट आई वांट प्रोवाइडेड आई गिव द राइट टू द अदर पर्सन टू से नो. ओके. आई हैव अ राइट टू माय ओन ओपिनियंस. आई हैव अ राइट टू टेक माय ओन डिसीजंस and face the consequences. I won't use the word face, you say cope with the consequences. See, once you become, I personally feel, I mean it's my opinion, I'm trying to, I live my life also accordingly and I allow others also accordingly to live their life, is that as long as what you're doing is not immoral or unethical or not illegal, you go ahead and do it. Don't care what the world says. Yeah, it is your right.
Yeah.
As long as you are not being immoral, you can't rob him and then go and spend money. But that is unethical, robbing somebody. Okay.
And one more, I don't know whether in this context it is right or not. We are all fallible human beings. So not right to make mistake, but sometimes mistakes.
No, it's there. Mistakes will happen. That is our right. As being human, being human will make mistakes. Okay. So we have these rights. You have a right to be successful.
Right.
Most of us feel that success is for somebody else, not for me. You think, arre, arre, apne liye nahi, apne bas ki baat nahi hai. We talk that way, okay? I have the right to change myself. Wo nahi bolega na, are you married? How many years you are married? 10, 15 years? Okay, almost. ना यार हस्बैंड इज टेलिंग हर, अरे जब शादी हुई थी तब ऐसी नहीं थी तुम, आजकल बहुत जवान निकल दिया. बहुत पीपल, आई हैव अ राइट, आई मे हैव बीन सबमिसिव ऑल माय लाइफ बट आई हैव अ राइट नाउ टू चेंज माय सेल्फ एंड बिकम असर्टिव. यू अंडरस्टैंड, यू हैव अ राइट टू चेंज, यू हैव अ राइट टू चेंज योर रिलीजन यू वर बॉर्न विथ, बट यू फील अशेम्ड इफ यू चेंज योर रिलीजन एंड सोसाइटी विल किल यू इफ यू चेंज योर रिलीजन. I'm just giving an example.
Yes.
You have that right. You have that right if you want to. No. As long as it's not illegal and it's not immoral.
Yes.
You see, because illegal means if you do anything against the law, then you have to face the consequences. Then, what else you want? So you understand about being right, no? You have a right to your own opinion, you have a right to make your own mistake. You have the right to say yes or no to any situation without feeling guilty. We feel guilty. Supposing you call me for your wedding, for your, not your wedding, say your son's wedding, and I'm not coming. If I'm assertive, I'll tell you very clearly, open on it. Rish, thanks a lot for inviting me. I wish you best of luck and wish your son best of luck, etc. I wish I could come, but I'm not able to come because I'm going out of Bombay, or because there's a function, or because I got a meeting, whatever it is. Simple, or Chandanabad. But what happens if I do that also, I feel guilty. Then he's such a good friend, for the last 8 years he has been coming for my lectures. And he has built up my confidence. You have built up my confidence, you see. We don't know, every little thing helps. And it also hurts people. Once you are aware of it, you will be very careful to before we open our mouth. So, that was the point. Now, how do we go about exercising your assertive rights? This is a right, I want to exercise it. So, there are a few things you can do. First thing is, you have to know exactly what you want.
Own awareness.
Oh no, exactly. I want to sleep up to 7 in the morning. So don't wake me before that, supposing. Then, yuck. If you vaguely say, no, sometimes I like to get up early, sometimes I like to get up late. Now, late is what? To Sirish, getting up at 6 o'clock will be late. To him, getting up at 9 o'clock also will be early. Now, who's going to decide that, you know? So you be what exactly you want. The boy asks the father, Dad, I want 100 rupees pocket money. Because I have this thing, etc. Kuch nahi, aajkal mahanga bahut hai, masala dosa zyada ho gaya, and all. That is going round and round. So be clear about what you want, what exactly you want. Second, say it. Articulate it. Don't bottle up, don't keep it inside yourself. And that is what we mostly do. You see, there's a joke, I don't know whether it's true, but I remember many years ago I used to use in my speeches. A Maharashtrian couple. They married and they were celebrating their 25th anniversary, wedding anniversary, you know. And they were living very happily, etc. And they had established a practice of every Saturday going to see a Marathi play, Marathi drama, you see. So, it went on. For 25 years, they were every Saturday they went, you know. Now, on this wedding anniversary day, they had their party and whatever it is. And of course, it is everything is related to religion also. You do puja also, etc. All that was done. Everything was okay, nice. Night they were about to go to sleep and all. Then the husband said, how did you like it, etc. They were talking about their life. Everything is okay. Then wife said, then husband said, I'm sorry, we could not go for the drama today. It was Saturday, so we could not go for the drama because of this. Then the wife said, thank God we could not go to the drama. I don't like Marathi dramas at all. And for 25 years you have been taking me, I finally. And the husband said, why didn't you tell me 25 years ago? Because I don't like Marathi drama. I thought you like them, therefore I was getting ticketed. So don't keep it. This may be an exaggerated story, but the point is very clear. Okay, so within it, say it, ask for it, whatever you want, whatever you try. And do it as soon as possible. Don't put it off. Don't delay. Kal bolega, parsu bolega. The more you delay, the more difficult you will find to do it. So say it. Okay. Then be specific when you say. Be very specific. Don't be vague, wishy-washy, etc. Kya cheez chahiye? Mujhe Marathi drama ki zindagi bhar dekhna nahi hai. Simple. That is clear. I'm not coming anytime. You can go with anybody. I'm not coming. Okay. Then, one important thing is, we have not used that word, but now we're coming. Be relaxed. When you're being assertive, be relaxed. Not only be relaxed, look relaxed also. See, your non-verbal communication should convey that you're relaxed. Be relaxed, look relaxed. Always look in the eye of the other person. In fact, most people don't do that. I don't know.
Be direct.
Be direct, openly. Look. that conveys a lot of confidence, you know, looking into the person's eyes, and you get a lot of feedback.
And many times things become simple if you do.
Samne wala bhi wahi chahiye unko. Correct. And one thing you'll do is not do, and which we do when you are trying to be assertive, is laugh nervously. Avoid that. Yes. You know, no, I want 100 rupees pocket money. Ab samajh gaya na kya bolta hai. So don't, that is nervously, you know, don't.
Nervous smile.
Yeah, and don't be sarcastic. Avoid this.
As if you are committing some crime.
Crime, correct, okay. In being assertive, there are three main components. Okay, one is your voice. Make sure that your voice is audible, clear, and it has a proper amount of emotion.
Yes.
See, because you are dealing with feelings, so don't over exaggerate your feelings, and don't be like talking to a wall or something like that. No. Yeah. Emotional. It should be appropriate. Okay, and your voice should be well modulated, audible. Your verbal communication should be well organized, from properly. You know, what is this? Not like my talk. No. Point, okay.
Point,
it comes, you know, then it fixes. So it should be well organized, okay? Well organized, expressive, honest, etc., everything, okay? And your non-verbal communication should be appropriate. Yeah, it should match it, should be congruent with that. Good eye contact, well-balanced posture, gestures, etc., okay? So these are the things you have to do. Now, two things you have to keep in mind. First thing is, assertiveness is not a cure-all.
Yes.
Assertiveness will not, in fact, very often it might put you into trouble. You have to be prepared for it, because, you know, people don't like others to change also.
Sometimes, yes.
Okay.
That is why situation is important.
Yeah, secondly. Yeah, we'll come to that. Ability to discern, I told you that,
yes.
Is very important when you're doing this. When I should say this, when I should do that, when I should be aggressive.
Proper timing,
proper judgment. Discerning means having good judgment. You judge the situation. And when two assertive persons meet, what will they do?
The result is success.
They respect each other. They will respect each other, and they will agree to disagree.
No.
And they will not be hurt. Whereas if it is an aggressive person, he'll get annoyed if you don't agree.
There will be a fight.
Yeah, there will be a fight. So, and if you want to practice being assertive, well, you do all these things which I told you, be specific, ask for what it is. Then do progressive relaxation technique. You know, I have talked about it, many others also must have talked about it. So relax yourself from head to toe, and in that relaxed state, start visualizing. Okay, do that way. Yeah? And then see yourself performing assertively in a situation which you want. Before that, you do a lot of homework. Jotting down any situation where you have behaved aggressively or you have behaved submissively, and you do, is it change that behavior? Then in that relaxed state, see that and then visualize that.
Actually, you are performing.
You are performing.
See the movie.
Yeah, see the movie, etc. And if you really want to be successful and make it, you alternate between, this is called imaging. Make images and actual performing.
Right.
So you keep on, you know, you go, something I wanted to be with you. So I come and I practice telling you, no, Mr. Sirish, this is not, I wanted this, etc. So that, then I actually do it.
Yes.
Then again go back and do it. So in course of time, that behavior will become a sad behavior, you will become assertive. Yeah? But assertive is not a cure-all. Take care about that. Okay. Over.
Good. Very good.
Thank you, sir. Good.
Timing.